ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಟೈಮ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು, ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಬೇರೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಗುಡ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ನೂನ್. ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ದ ಟಾಪಿಕ್ ವಿಚ್ ಡೆಲ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಬಯೋಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್. ವಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟೆಡ್ ಸೋ ಫಾರ್ ಬಯೋಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಇನ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಜನರೇಟ್ ಅ ಬಿಟಿ ಕಾಟನ್ and production of pest resistant plant, that is tobacco. In biotechnological applications of medicines, nearly 30 drugs which are developed worldwide. One such drug out of 12 in India which is presently marketed called as insulin. The production of insulin was also discussed in yesterday's class, last previous class. And next part of the biotechnology is all about remove a faulty gene from the body, and replace with a normal functional gene. That is the word called gene therapy, as the word indicates. It is very clear and evident to understand some of the faulty genes present in the body cells. We'll remove these faulty genes and replace with the normal functional genes, replace with the good genes. So clear cut, it is the process of the meaning of this gene therapy, removal of a faulty gene, means it is understood as non-functional. Remove a non-functional faulty gene and replace with a functional healthy gene. So that gives the meaning called gene therapy. And the concept was said like, we get these genes, whether they are normal or whether they are a faulty or defective gene. So these most cases, these defective genes, they are inherited from parents. Has biotechnology possible to correct this disease? Yes, it is to some extent. Biotechnology has given a relief of curing these defective genes present in the body by replacing a good healthy genes into this person who is suffering from diseases, defective genes coming from parents. They could get from grandparents, means it inherits through generations. So how is this gene therapy possible? One instance and major 5-mark concept is discussed in the textbook. But before that, I wanted to introduce you, like, gene therapy, how many types are there? Where do you do this correction? Where are the genes corrected in the body? Gene therapy will be of two types. Remove the faulty gene, replace a normal functional gene. It is of two types. Gene therapy is done in somatic cells, which is nothing but body cells. And second, gene therapy is done at germ cells, that is reproductive cells. To clearly know that, the diagram on the board is entire body containing tissues, bone marrow, it could be his any of the organ. So generally in the body organ, if I could remove these faulty genes of his body, removal of these faulty genes and replace with a normal functional gene occurring in the body cells of a person, then this gene therapy shall be called as somatic cell gene therapy. But kindly notes, this does not go to next generation. It remains only for this person, because somatic cells are non-inheritable. They do not pass to next generation. The correction of the faulty gene by a new gene will remain only to this person, because somatic cells do not pass to next generation. Germline gene therapy is possible to remove a faulty gene and replace a normal gene. Removal of a faulty gene and replacement of a normal gene is done in the reproductive cells, which are called spermatozoa or human egg cells, or it could be even a embryo of the human being. So if we remove the faulty gene from the spermatozoa, remove the faulty gene which is from the ovum, correct? So this is sperm and this will be the ovum, and even this is embryo after fertilization. Both sperm and ova after fertilization shall produce an embryo. If we remove that faulty gene from these cells, spermatozoa, ovum, embryo, and replace with a functional gene in this level, that becomes a permanent correction, because this will pass on to next generation. The gamete with the corrected gene will fuse with the normal ova, and thus the embryo means coming up zygote, that is the offspring, will be normal. Or if the defective gene is replaced and corrected in the ovum of the female in vitro, that is in the lab condition, so the coming up generation, that is embryo and zygote, will be also having a normal gene. And last, in case if this is not possible, a zygote of 2 cells or 4 cells or 8 cells, there also it is possible to replace with a good functional gene and remove the faulty gene. At embryonic level is also possible, because embryo is what develops into fetus, that is a child coming up in the mother's womb. This is the permanent solution. Actually, this is only for the person, and it could be a temporary solution. So but to this time being concerned, this permission is not granted by the government till now. So in the entire world, no permission is granted for gene therapy at spermatozoa, ovum or embryo level. Permission and possibilities are done only at the somatic or body cells level. So NCERT textbook has given what is gene therapy, explain gene therapy done at the level of body cells, that is somatic cells. So we shall start a 5-mark question. How shall we remove and pass a good gene into the body of a person? It's a case study. It occurred in 1990. The first gene therapy took place in 1990. It is a somatic cell gene therapy. So the first case of the gene therapy took place in 1990s on a 4-year-old girl. The girl is named as Ashanti De Silva. So the person that 4-year-old girl had a deficiency means a faulty gene. We are now focusing on which is the defective gene to replace with a normal gene. The person was having a deficiency, that is has a faulty gene known as ADA gene. Only one gene was faulty in the body of this 4-year-old girl, and the gene is titled as ADA. Its full form goes adenosine deaminase. The gene produces an enzyme called, correct? in the last chapters, we have said that definitely gene makes a protein or an enzyme. Gene makes protein or an enzyme. Now the gene is a faulty gene. It is not able to produce the enzyme named as adenosine deaminase. So gene is not able to create an enzyme called adenosine deaminase. So ADA gene is absent in this person. In this person, there is deficiency of, there is no functioning of ADA gene. Now question arises, this ADA gene which makes enzyme called adenosine deaminase, what is the function of this enzyme? Why did we need this enzyme in the body? Why do we need this enzyme in the body? Question arises. It is to be noticed that adenosine deaminase is needed for functioning of WBC cells. Correct? It is very much essential for functioning of WBC cells. Now, when this person is not having ADA gene, the person's WBC cells become non-functional. Kindly understand. The girl has a defective ADA gene. The girl is not able to synthesize adenosine deaminase enzyme, which was necessary to produce functional WBC cells. When WBC cells are not functioning in the body, the person's immune system is weakened. The person has low immune system. The girl has low immune system in her body. See the condition. We have not yet started how to correct this gene. We have just said that the body is having a defective gene called ADA that was necessary for functioning of a WBC cells. Because of the non-production of adenosine deaminase in her body, the girl has non-functional WBC because no ADA gene is functioning, and her immune system is very much low, weakening of immune system. So when body T lymphocytes, B lymphocytes are not functioning, I hope you heard this in the chapter called Human Health and Disease, her B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes will not be functioning, the girl is facing a severe problem called severe combined immunodeficiency, does not have any immune system functioning, that is no T lymphocytes and no functioning of B lymphocytes. So no resistance against any pathogens. The girl has no resistance powers against any pathogens. She is suffering from a collection of disease called SCID. That is, because of low immune system, the person has a body condition called severely combined immunodeficiency. Yes, this is the case. This is the case in that 4-year-old girl. Now, question would arise, how shall we treat this person to overcome this ADA gene? So, let me revise the entire thing once again. What is gene therapy? Remove the faulty gene from the person and replace it with normal functional gene. So this replacement can be done at 2 levels. If it is done in the level of the body, body cells, body tissues, bone marrow, we call this as somatic cell gene therapy. If it is done in the body of the person, that is at gametes, spermatozoa, ovum or embryo level, correction of the gene, then it will be called as germline gene therapy. But germline gene therapy is not allowed, permitted so far till now. In this particular gene therapy, a case with 4-year-old girl, in 1990s, first attempt was made to cure gene therapy in this person. Gene therapy on this person. Here, the person is not having one gene functioning. That one gene is known as ADA gene, which is supposed to produce an enzyme called adenosine deaminase. So non-functional ADA gene, adenosine deaminase enzyme is not produced in the person. Hence, the functioning of WBC cells is not occurring. When WBC cells are not functioning, that is T and B lymphocytes are non-functioning in the body, the person is having a low immune system, that is immune resistance in the body is totally lost. The body is exposed to group of diseases. The person suffers from a series of illness which is called as severely combined immunodeficiency. Now, how to treat this person with gene therapy? There are two methods. There are two approaches to treat this gene therapy process. There are two approaches on this gene therapy. The present case, one is enzyme replacement method. And the second one is bone marrow transplantation. So these are the two approaches to treat this person who is having ADA deficiency. In enzyme replacement method, could notice in the case one, enzyme replacement method, directly the person is injected ADA enzyme into her body tissues. It is a process of directly giving the ADA enzyme into her body's tissues, that is the bone marrow, for WBCs to function, but that was not actual method and it was not at all significant. So later some better method was adopted on the person, that is bone marrow transplantation. So what was this bone marrow transplantation? We know that the person bone has a soft tissue into which the WBC RBCs are produced. So we call this cavity within the bone as bone marrow. In case one, directly injection of ADA enzyme was being done. But in case two, from the bone, the tissue is extracted, which is called as bone marrow. So in bone marrow transplantation, the person's bone marrow tissue is taken out, isolated, which is nothing but immature WBC cells, bone marrow cells containing WBCs, white blood corpuscles. So bone marrow tissue is extracted concerned to WBCs. So these WBCs are having a defective gene. So now let me take this single cell of WBC. This WBC cell, which has a defective gene, correct, within its nucleus, the WBCs which are extracted, these extracted WBCs are now cultured in a petri dish. They are cultured in a petri dish, and this defective gene will now be replaced by using a vector. We use a vector here which is called as retrovirus. So the vector here used is retroviruses. You could remember this in the previous chapter. We have said the virus which act as a vector to transfer the gene into the animal cell will be retrovirus. The vector which transfers the gene into the plant cell will be Agrobacterium tumefaciens. Retroviruses used as a vector. Now retrovirus is made disarmed pathogen. It is now no more harmful, it is harmless. Now a functional ADA gene is transferred into this retrovirus. Now this is functional ADA gene. Functional ADA gene is loaded, transferred into retrovirus. the retrovirus is now a disarmed pathogen, retrovirus will now infest this WBC cells which are cultured in this petri dish. So large number of retroviruses will carry a functional ADA gene, and those viruses will release this functional ADA gene into this WBC cells, which now WBC cells, shall I change the color in terms of yellow, it indicates in this non-functional gene you are now getting a functional gene. So retroviruses vector method will release. So the picture exactly goes like this. Virus binds and virus will release its content of the gene into the WBC cells. So once again revise. In the second method, bone marrow transplantation, the person's bone marrow tissue, which is immature WBC cells, they are isolated, they are extracted out from the bone marrow of that particular person. The WBCs are shifted onto a petri dishes. These WBCs, which have a defective gene, these WBC cells, but once a WBC cell is taken, this group of WBC cells are allowed to infest by the retrovirus, which is disarmed. By using REN, the pathogenic gene was cut off by REN and functional ADA gene was joined by using a ligase. Now this recombinant DNA was released into the WBCs, and these WBC cells will be further cultured, means they are allowed to multiply, they are allowed to grow. Multiply becomes a wrong word. These WBC cells are cultured, means they are allowed to grow. Now these cultured WBCs, these cultured WBC cells will be once again released into the person's bone marrow, correct? Into her bone marrow. These cultured WBCs, which contains adenosine deaminase gene, which contains adenosine deaminase gene, this WBCs will now be injected into this person's what you call bone marrow, will be released into this bone marrow. But do you think, is this a cell active for a long duration? No, because we know that WBCs are alive only for 10 to 12 days, lifespan of WBCs is hardly 10 to 12 days, and these are mortal cells. They are not immortal. We want a cell which is not immortal, right? These are mortal cells. That is the problem over here. So this needs periodic infusion. Injection of this cultured WBC cells with functional ADA cells, it needs periodic infusion as these WBCs are mortals. That is short-lived. This is the problem concerned to gene therapy now. We took the WBC of the person, we used a retrovirus, and retrovirus delivered the functional ADA gene into this person's WBC in the petri dishes. The cells were allowed to culture. Then these cells from the culture plates are once again injected through into its bone marrow. But the problem is that these WBC cells need periodic infusion. Repeatedly we have to inject this person, and these WBCs are short lived. They are mortals. We want a WBC which is not immortal, but these WBC cells are mortals. So last question arises, what is the permanent cure means? What is the permanent cure? Is that permanent cure was last statement, if it was done at the level of embryonic stages. Permanent cure would have been done if it was been done at the embryonic stage. But what to do? That permission is not granted. So the girl needs to get periodically injected with the functional ADA gene containing WBCs into her body for the survival. this completed the concept of gene therapy. So we shall revise for last 2 minutes, then start with the CET program. So let me begin once again. Remove of a faulty gene from the body. So removal of the faulty gene from the body and replace with a normal functional gene will be called as gene therapy. So the first gene therapy case was done on a 4-year-old girl in 1990s. The person had a problem with ADA gene. ADA gene is adenosine deaminase, which is responsible for functioning of WBC cells. Because of non-functional of WBC cells, the person had severely combined immunodeficiency. Therefore, what is to be done? From the bone marrow, WBC cells are extracted. These WBC cells are then exposed to the retroviruses, which contains a functional ADA gene. Now this disarmed retrovirus will deliver these ADA gene into this WBC cells, and these cells will be cultured and allowed to grow. Such WBC cells which contains functional ADA gene will now be transported back into this girl's bone marrow cells. But problem is that this is needs periodic infusion, as WBC cells are not immortals, right? They are mortals. That is, these WBC cells are short lived. So that created problem. Hence, for a permanent cure, this would have been done when the person was in the embryonic stages. So enough for today. Deal with some few questions of biotechnological applications. So the first question here, identify the area not involved in biotechnological research. Downstreaming process to purify the protein, is it a part of biotechnology? Yes. Question, not involved in biotechnological research. Downstreaming processing to get a purified compound, it is there. Developed a improved microbe or a pure enzyme as the best catalyst. It is also there. To create human clones, is it a part of biotechnology to create one more copy of my own kind? This is not an approach of biotechnology. So we said in the beginning of the class, there are three approaches, critical approaches. Create a best catalyst, create second optimum conditions through catalyst to act. Third thing is that downstreaming process to purify the compound. So these were the three critical research areas of biotechnology said in the beginning of the chapter. So this was the first step, create a catalyst, pure enzyme, then give optimum condition for the enzyme and microbe to produce the product. Last is obtain the product downstreaming and purify. Third is not a part of biotechnology. So next question. In which field application of biotechnology occurs? Now you have studied only three fields, but overall also we have spoken which are the different fields of biotechnology, that is applications of biotechnology. Biotech has its application in medicine, correct? It has. Biotech has its application in agriculture also, it is correct. It has even its application environmental, that is what you call energy production, sewage treatment, etc., etc. So all the above is the correct answer. First is also there, second is also there. Environmental field means sewage treatment also is a part of biotech, correct? Energy production also comes there. So all of the above will be the right suitable word for this. Next question. in which following form the improved catalyst is produced using biotechnology? When you take the microbe or its enzyme, correct? Microbe or pure enzyme? Already answer was said. Which form of improved catalyst is produced means, what do you take in biotechnology? Do we take microbe or pure enzyme? It is correct. We take either microbe or its enzyme. Do we take inorganic compounds? No. For this REN and ligase to act upon, do we take inorganic compound? No. Enter organism, that's also wrong. None of the above is also wrong. We take an improved catalyst in the form of microbe or in the form of a pure enzyme. That is the first what critical research area. What did you take for biotechnology means? I took a microbe or I took a pure enzyme. So second, third and fourth is not possible. Only the first option is possible. Next. Which following strategies cannot be considered for increasing food production? For food production, there were three options. I hope you remember some green revolution was spoken. In that case, what were the different methods for improved food production? Agrochemical based agriculture was there. Yes, it was there. You pour a lot of fertilizers, chemicals. Genetically engineered crop based, yes, presently going on. BT cotton is there, BT corn, BT brinjal, BT tobacco, etc. This is also there. Maximum use of chemical fertilizer, this was not at all an option. We don't want to use chemical fertilizers. Organic agriculture is also there. Organic agriculture using a biopesticide, bioinsecticide, cow dung manure, organic agriculture is one of the option. Genetically engineered crop is also an option, and that agrochemical based was also option. Third one, maximum use of chemical fertilizer is not at all an option. So this will be the answer, which cannot be considered. Next. Why, what is the success for green revolution? Why did green revolution got a succeeded? Is green revolution concerned to production of BT cotton? No. Green revolution succeeded in tripling of food supply? Yes. You said from 1960s to 2000, the food production got raised to three times. So some 11 to 15 million tons per year was being produced, which got improved to 70 to 80 tons. Tripling of food supply is the correct thing. Green revolution, increasing the yield with existing varieties, no, we created new varieties. Production of pest resistant plants, so that is because of biotechnology. Green revolution succeeded because of tripling the food supply, production of more food. Next, organisms. Organism, say a plant or say an animal whose genes are taken and manipulated are known as dash. Are taken gene from one organism and introduced into the body of the another organism. What do you call for this creature as? So the gene is thrown into another organism. What do you call this creature as means? Genetically stable organism, genetically modified organism, chemically modified or synthetic? No, it should be genetically modified organism. Remember, there is a word called GMO in the textbook, GMO. So one creature gets the gene from some other creature. So what do you call that creature as who carries the foreign gene? I call that creature as genetically modified organism. You have heard two creatures in the class previously. BT cotton is genetically modified plant, correct? It's a GM crop. BT tobacco is also GM crop, etc. So next, BT toxin is produced by, if you remember on the concept called as BT cotton, there is a bacteria in the soil called as Bacillus thuringiensis. You have taken the gene from that and transferred it into the cotton plant. So BT toxin is actually taken from the bacteria Bacillus thermoglucosidaris. No, Bacillus thuringiensis, correct. Bacillus atrophius, wrong. Thermus aquaticus, it comes in the polymerase chain reaction. So you would have gone for Bacillus thuringiensis, BT for Bacillus thuringiensis. Next question. Nine. the crystals produced by Bacillus thuringiensis contain the bacteria which you say it as Bacillus thuringiensis. It will definitely produce some proteins in its body. What do you call for that proteins? Question asked. So I call this as non-toxic insecticidal protein, toxic carbohydrates, toxic insecticidal lipids, or toxic insecticidal proteins. Kindly A, B, C, D. Yes. In the body of the bacteria, what protein was produced? Is it a non-toxic? No, sorry, it is toxic. Toxic insecticidal is correct, but carbohydrate would have not been used. Toxic insecticidal, again, lipid would have not been used. Toxic insecticidal protein is the right answer. Produced, which for insect is toxic insecticidal protein. Next. The genes which are responsible to control cotton bollworms. Good. We know this acronym word CRY. CRY stands for crystal. So, there were three genes taken from the bacteria, Bacillus thuringiensis, crystal 1AC, crystal 2AB to control cotton bollworms, crystal 1AB for corn borer. But question is asked, to control cotton bollworms and corn borer, R dash and dash means cotton bollworms will be 1AC, 2AB, 1AC, 2AB. This is both for cotton bollworms. 1AB is meant for corn borer. So now this cannot be the answer. 2AB and 1AB, 2AB for this, 1AB for this, correct? 2AC, no, does not exist. 1AB, 1AC, no, this is needs to be interchanged, so this is also wrong thing. So 2AB for ball worm and 1AB for a corn borer is the right answer. Next. Which following statement is wrong in relation to transgenic BT cotton plant? We have to read all the first sentence and cell, which is wrong statement for BT cotton. BT cotton crop yield loss due to attack of Bacillus thuringiensis bacterium is reduced. Crop yield loss because of attack of bacteria? No, bacteria does not attack the cotton at all. Crop yield loss due to attack by Lepidopteran insect pest is reduced. Yes, BT cotton now crop yield loss is reduced because that no insects are attacking the BT cotton. Because if any insect attack BT cotton, the insect will die. Question, why did the insect die means? The protoxins in the body of the insect converts into active toxins at pH 12, that is alkaline condition. So, crop yield loss due to attack by Lepidopteran insect pest is reduced would be the answer. Use of chemical insecticide in cotton field, no, we don't use any chemical insecticide. Better quality cotton is produced also is not the answer. Second one, crop yield loss due to attack of Lepidopteran is reduced. BT cotton are not been implied or attacked by the group of insects because I have the resistance. The BT cotton has a resistance. Next. Again, incorrect statement regarding BT cotton. Dried spores of BT are sprayed on the vulnerable leaves. Do you spray the dried spores of BT on the leaves? No. BT cotton releases toxin that causes swelling in the gut of insect that injects its leaves, word is given. BT cotton releases toxin that causes swelling, or BT cotton is a transgenic plant. It is producing toxin due to gene introduced by its transgenesis. Oh my goodness. Very much word, what is incorrect statement? Already the first one, as you said, because it releases toxin which causes swelling in the insect, it dies. It's a transgenic plant, genetically modified plant. It will produce toxin due to introduction of gene. The first one, which is incorrect, is dried spores. We don't take any spores, we don't spray it on the plant. So first will be the answer. Incorrect statement is the A. B, C and D are the correct statements. Next, 12th. In BT cotton, the BT toxin present in the plant tissue as protoxin is converted into active toxin due to, very nice, what causes conversion? In the bacteria, it is protoxin. In the insect, when it goes, it converts into toxin. That is active toxin. Why? Because acidic nature of insect? No. Action of the microbes present in the body? No. presence of conversion factors in insect, no. Or alkaline pH of the insect, yes. So when the toxin, protoxin enters into insect body, at alkaline condition, which is a pH 12, it becomes into active toxin. So 1, 2, 3 is not the answer, because read the question. The BT toxin present in the plant tissue as protoxin is converted into active toxin due to alkaline pH of the insect gut at 12. Next, assertion and reason. In BT cotton, Bacillus thuringiensis produces a toxic insecticidal crystal protein which destroyed bollworms. Correct? So, BT produced a toxic insecticidal crystalline protein which destroys bollworms. Correct? BT toxin produces. Next, BT produces this toxin protein in an inactive form, but when an insect ingests this inactive protoxin, it converted into active form of toxin due to the alkaline pH of gut, which solubilizes the crystals responsible for the death of the bollworm. Complete paragraph given according to NCRT. Assertion is also correct. Reason is also correct. Correct. Therefore, the insect dies because at alkaline condition. So what is the option? Means assertion is correct and reason is wrong. Wrong and correct, both assertion and reason both are correct, but reason is not the explanation. Assertion and reason both are correct, and reason is the correct explanation of assertion. So answer will be the fourth one. Both are perfect statements and both are having the connection. Next, 14th question. Acidic pH of insect gut converts inactive BT toxin into active form. Is it the word acidic pH or alkaline pH? It should have been alkaline pH. Correct, it is acidic word is given, therefore statement A is wrong statement. Most of the BT toxins are insect group specific. Correct, they kill only group of insects. You have already said lepidopterans, coleopterans, armyworms, budworms, dipterans, etc. So they are insect specific. R is correct. A wrong, because acidic pH is not the answer, it is alkaline pH. At 12 is alkaline condition. So I will go with A and R are true, no. A and R are true and R is the correct, no. A is true, R is false. So answer should be fourth one. A is false, R is true. A is false and R is true. Next. BT expresses proteins that do not provide resistance against. Nice question. BT, the bacteria which has proteins, protoxins, it is harmful to tobacco budworms, correct? It kills coleopterans, is also correct. It kills mosquitoes, is also correct. But BT is toxin on fungus, is not correct. How does it attack fungus? So this, for the option fourth, fourth will be the wrong answer, which do not have resistance against the fungus. Next. Meliodegen incognita is an example of dash. Meliodegen incognita is an example of a dash. Bacteria, virus, fungi and a nematode. So Meliodegen incognita is nothing but a nematode. It's a Ascalmanthus group, which causes root knot disease in the plants of the tobacco, etc., tomato, etc. So Meliodegen incognita is not a bacteria, is not a virus, is not a fungus. This is a nematode of Ascalmanthus. Next question. Which part of the tobacco plant is infected by Meliodegen incognita is asked. When the nematode attacks the plant, which part of the plant is having problem? Concern 2, question is NEET phase 1, 16 was asked. Meliodegen incognita attacks the stem, root, flower or leaf is asked here. Question is, it doesn't affect stem, it affects the root. It affects the root. Flower, leaf, no. So this parasite causes root knot disease, therefore option will be B. Another 3 questions, will stop for 20. 18th, The strategy used to prevent infestation of tobacco plant by Meliodegen incognita is, very nice question, what do you call that process which is developed in the tobacco plant to stop attack of this nematode is, do you call RNA interferon or DNA interference, RNA interference, DNA interferon? So we know that word very well. It is called a mRNA silencing, better given as RNA interference. RNAi is the word used here. It is RNA interference, right? DNA is not possible. How the mRNA of the nematode will be binded with one more RNA and creating a double stranded. So that is silencing of mRNA is been said in the last class. So this is RNA interference. Next, this is a method of cellular defense in all eukaryotes. The same question asked in some other format. In every cell, we said in the previous class before yesterday, cell will be having a mechanism. If any other mRNA enters, it becomes double and stop the process of protein synthesis. So we call this as method cellular defense in all eukaryotes. It is DNA interferon, RNA interferon, DNA interference or RNA interference. Again, the same answer is, this method is called RNA interference. Last question. Identify the incorrect statement with respect to RNAi technology. RNAi takes place in all eukaryotic organisms. It is correct. It takes place in all eukaryotic cells. Whatever creating RNA into double, right? So doubling the mRNA, making one more mRNA bind to this and creating it double. This takes place in all eukaryotic organisms is a correct statement. RNA interference is a method of cellular defense in eukaryotic organisms is also correct. So third one, the source of complementary RNA in RNAi could be from viruses with RNA genome and transposons that replicate. This is also correct. So you would have asked the question, how does the mRNA binds with one more mRNA and become double? Because of some RNA has come from viruses or might have been come from transposons or jumping genes. This is also correct. Last, RNAi involves the silencing of specific mRNA due to presence of a complementary ssRNA. It should be double stranded RNA, complementary double stranded RNA. So RNAi will be silenced by adding one more mRNA, right? An mRNA with another mRNA. Now this becomes complementary. You should not have used the word single stranded RNA. You would have been used the word double stranded RNA. So incorrect will be A is correct, B is also correct, C is also correct. D last statement will remain a incorrect statement. So again, we'll continue in the next classes. Some more questions concerned to gene therapy, which was discussed today, shall be again continued question from 21 onwards in the coming upper classes. So that's all for today. Thank you.